What's up, Internet? This video is for people who want to learn how to trade cryptocurrencies, including Bitcoin and Ethereum, but you're just starting out, you're a beginner, and you're not quite sure how to do it. Well, we do have a live stream every month about crypto. Napansin ko lang na I've never actually made an explainer video on how to trade cryptocurrencies. This will be that video. Plus, this is like a trilogy of videos. Itong number one natin, how to trade cryptocurrencies for beginners. Number two, five things you don't need to know about crypto before you start trading. Ang dami kasing natatakot na they need to know so much before they start trading. That's not true, and we'll talk about it in that video. And the third are the people on X or on Twitter that you should be following. Yung mga analysts na matino, na may sense yung mga pinapost nila, so that you have an idea about the trades you might want to be making or the coins that you might want to consider investing in. And of course, that trilogy of videos would not be possible without our sponsor.
Sawa ka na ba sa unactivated Windows mo? Well, lucky you! Pinakabago mula sa cdkeyoffer.com. Windows 10 and Windows 11 activation codes. Legit, safe, at pinakamura. Madali lang umorder!
Hanapin ang Windows version na gusto mo. Piliin ang preferred payment method. Wala pang 5 minutes, nagsisigi ka na para sa Windows mo.
Marami na kaming natulungan!
Dati, sadong depressed ako. But now, I found the love of my life!
Dati, aimless and walang purpose ang life ko. But now, I'm a world-class Zumba instructor!
So, web developer ako and content creator for a YouTube channel. And ngayon, ganun pa rin ako pero activated na yung Windows ko.
Kaya ako naghahanap ka ng legit, mura, at original software.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
Check out cdkoffer.com.
Now, this first video will be about how to create an account so that you can start trading cryptocurrencies. Hindi siya tungkol sa trading strategies, kung anong coins ka dapat mag-i-invest, at what price you should sell, at what price you should buy. Trading techniques na yun. For this video, this is for the very beginner, iniisip pa lang niya ano yung kailangan kong gawin para mag-trade ng crypto. Tapos yung target audience niya, yung mga nasa Pilipinas. So the exchanges we'll be talking about and what you need to do to get on those exchanges are Philippine-based. But the general principles are also applicable for other nationalities if you're thinking of jumping into crypto from wherever you're based. So to start trading crypto, there are just two basic steps. Number one, sign up to a local exchange. An exchange that's based in your home country or where you're currently residing. Kung nasa Pilipinas ka, you probably already have an exchange right on your phone. Via GCash, you can already trade cryptocurrencies. So you do need to have a GCash account and then you click through the options. You do need to give GCash a little bit more information about yourself on your risk appetite. But basically, click lang yan and then makaka-trade ka na. Now, GCash crypto trading is powered by PIDAX, which is a separate local exchange. I actually don't recommend GCash. If you're serious about making this a sideline or as a hobby, it's better to trade through a primary exchange. And in the Philippines, that's either PIDAX or coins.ph. Now, if you go online, you'll hear a lot of complaints about both PIDAX and coins.ph. Huwag mo silang pansinin. I've been on both for quite a number of years now, and both have what you should be looking for. Number one, stability. Number two, ease of use. Yung coins.ph at PIDAX, pareho silang may ganun. And they're easy to sign up. Na palagi ko nakikita sa mga local crypto forums, huwag ka sumali sa CEX or a centralized exchange. All of the exchanges, you know, PIDAX, coins.ph, Kraken, Binance, etc. Lahat yun centralized exchange. Yung sinasabi ng mga tao, use a decentralized exchange or DEX. I don't recommend that for beginners because one, the centralized exchanges are a lot easier to sign up. It's a lot faster to start trading. And that's what you want to do. When you have an interest in something, gusto mo na magsimula, simulan mo. Don't wait. Huwag mapakinggan palagi yung mga negatives. Know that they're just stumbling blocks na pwedeng daanan that can be overcome. Iba-ibang options yan depending on how new you are to the space and what you need. But for a beginner trader, I really don't see any problem with centralized exchanges. Now, the criticisms of these exchanges are because they're so big, hindi maganda yung trading fees. And a lot of people get hung up over the trading fees. Don't. Huwag mo munang isipin yung trading fees. Nagsisimula ka pa lang. Concentrate on setting up an account and getting used to trading. Bibili ka ng Bitcoin habang mababa, ibibenta mo habang mataas. In the greater scheme of things, even high trading fees are not that high compared to what you might be making. Don't focus on the negatives yet. Focus on getting yourself going. So number one, sign up to a local exchange. In the Philippines, I would suggest PIDAX or coins.ph because they're reliable and they're easy to use. The sign-up procedure for both sites is very easy. If you're used to doing things on the internet, the sign-up process is very similar. You will need to send some IDs as these are financial sites. Regulatory stuff asks them to take your ID and they ask you about your risk appetite and things like that. Pero madali lang gawin, straightforward siya. So step one, done. Get yourself on a local exchange. And actually, you don't need to do anything after that. You can already start buying and selling crypto. But once you get comfortable, familiar with your local exchange, I really suggest signing up to an international exchange. One of the most prominent is Binance or Binance. Yung problema, baka ma-shutdown yung access natin dito sa Pilipinas. Pero marami pang ibang international exchanges. Bybit, OKX, ang dami-dami pang iba na legit naman. If you're wondering which exchange I've used, I actually don't use Binance. For almost 10 years now, I think I've been using Kraken. So what I like about Kraken is that it's a major exchange. Malaki siya, maganda yung security niya. But it's not one of the super big players. Yun nga, hindi siya top of mind like Binance. So medyo under the radar pa rin siya. Why do I suggest signing up also to a foreign exchange? Kasi ang daming options available sa mga foreign exchanges na wala sa atin. Una pa lang yung number of cryptocurrencies available for trading. Very limited dito sa atin. Bitcoin, Ethereum, XRP, sobrang basic na mga yun. But once you get on a local exchange, especially Binance, actually yung Kraken medyo mahina pa, medyo mabagal pa sila magdagdag ng mga bagong crypto. But yung Binance, sobrang bilis nila magdagdag. If you wanna jump on meme coins, it's very slow getting to the local exchanges here. But if you wanna jump on the next Shiba Inu, the next Dogecoin, Binance and other exchanges are your ticket. So foreign exchanges allow you variety in the types of crypto, ano yung mga coins na pwede mong i-trade, and also your funding options because foreign exchanges allow collateral or futures trading. You'll deposit a certain asset, whether it's US dollar or some other crypto, and the exchange will allow you to borrow on the strength of that security kasi hawak nila yon. You can borrow a lot of money to invest again in crypto. If you're a beginner, please don't do that yet. Get some experience before you start futures trading. But it is an option. And futures trading is like crazy yung mga multipliers doon. Like 10x, 50x, like how much you can borrow against your existing collateral. Sa totoo lang, you can start with a very small amount and it can grow very quickly using the futures option on the major exchanges abroad. Pero ba't di ko sinabi na tumalon ka na lang kagad dun sa foreign exchange? Because you can't send money to a foreign exchange. If you're based in the Philippines and you want to send them US dollars or Philippine pesos, mahirap or impossible. The easiest way to get your money into a foreign exchange so that you can start trading is also via crypto. So yung ginagawa ko, or yung ginawa ko dati, kasi matagal na ako sa foreign exchange, bumili ako ng crypto with a local exchange here using Philippine pesos. So let's say bumili ako ng Ethereum using Philippine pesos, may Ethereum na ako, yun yung pinadala ko sa foreign exchange because foreign exchanges will accept transfers in cryptocurrencies. Pwede ko na siya ibenta for US dollar. Etas yun, paikot-ikot na yun. Then I'll use that USD to buy another cryptocurrency. I'm gonna sell that. Hopefully, lalaki yung USD ko or lalaki yung crypto holdings ko in the foreign exchange. Pero yung seed money, yung una mong ilalagay sa foreign exchange, galing yun sa crypto na binili mo from our local exchanges. That's why you need to do step one first, local exchange, before step two, the foreign exchange. And you don't need to rush. Yun nga, take your time. get used to the prices, get used to the flow of the markets, and you can do that with the local exchange. When you want more variety, when you want more options, when you want to have a little bit more risk in your life, you can buy crypto at a local exchange and send it to a foreign exchange. And there are so many, it's like a whole world opens up to you. Grabe yung mga available na options on the foreign exchanges. So how to trade crypto if you're a beginner in 2 easy steps. Number 1, sign up to a local exchange. Kung may GCash ka, local exchange na yon. And number 2, once you have a little experience under your belt, sign up to a foreign exchange. Sobrang simple lang niya. At least the mechanics of how to start trading. This is not financial advice. I'm not telling you should start trading. There are a lot of risks. Actually, yung advice ko lang talaga, if you do start trading, use only money that you are 100% confident na okay lang na mawala. You put in 1,000 pesos, kung maging zero yung 1,000 pesos na yan, dapat okay lang sa financial status mo. Hindi ka magugutom, makakabayad ka pa ng kuryente, makakapasok pa rin yung anak mo sa eskwelahan. Only put in money that you are 100% comfortable losing. Kasi wild talaga yung crypto. And that's really my only advice. My advice isn't get into it. My advice isn't you shouldn't get into it. My advice is if you are putting money into crypto, it should be money that you are willing to kiss and say bye-bye to. Maari nga sobrang lumaki yung pera na yon, pero maari din na sobrang lumiit siya to zero. Personally though, I really do believe that crypto is a very good investment. I have invested a substantial amount of my personal funds in crypto, and I try to help people that are new to the space, just like how I try to help people who are new to the PC space. So not financial advice, but if you are thinking of getting into crypto and are wondering how to do it, ano ba kailangan gawin, saan ka magsa-sign up para makasimula ka, I hope this video was useful.
Paminsan, may nagtatanong kung may kilala ba kaming computer shop na trusted, yung hindi ka lolokohin. Actually, meron. Kami. Full-service PC store ang Hardware Sugar. Nagbabenta kami ng PC components. Nagbabenta rin kami ng fully assembled rigs. We clean computers. Kasama na rin yung excellent cable management namin and CPU cooler repasting sa cleaning. We also clean and repaste GPUs. Nasa Makati yung physical store namin, and you can also buy from our site, www.hwsugar.ph, na 100% palaging up-to-date yung inventory dun. Kung in-stock yung item sa amin, available yun sa site. We also ship nationwide. Thanks for watching, and maybe one of these days, magkita tayo sa shop.